I got my bachelor's degree in business, my master's in public administration, and I worked in education for over 12 years. But this has always been a passion of mine, and being a business owner.
Fitness is a fad, yeah, because some people get in it, they do it for a little while, but they stop. What is how has this experience been for you?
It's been doing good for me. Like, I think, I'm gonna do fitness for the rest of my life, essentially. But it is a fad, and I feel like a lot of people are, they see a lot of things on social media, so they wanna do it and stuff like that. But, like, I don't have nothing to do with that, like, in terms of, like, my energy and my devotion to what this is, like, is well beyond that, because my foundation is actually helping people at the end of the day. Like, I literally started in a park, charging people $5 to train them. Like, that's a real thing, you know what I'm saying? So to, see where I came from then to now, and again, my foundation is still helping people, so.
And this is a total career change for you.
It is.
What made you get into this? Like, how did you get started? You could be doing anything right
yeah,
about now.
Yeah. I pledged Phi Beta Sigma in college, so I was in a fraternity, and everybody know when you perform and you need to be in a certain type of condition, doing 10 to 12 minute shows. So that's what kind of got me into fitness, and I've always been an athlete all my life. I've been an athlete my whole life, so I always just like to work out and stuff like that.
Yeah, look, let's spin it this way. Ready? Come on.
Been doing this since 2020. There's been some ups, there's been some downs. Mm-hmm. Explain to our people, like, what's been those ups and what's been those downs.
So I've been doing this in terms of a gym ownership from 2020. I've been certified since 16, but I've been training since 2009, right? So in terms of, being a gym owner since 2020, some of the ups, again, the profit, the camaraderie in terms of, the clients you have and the relationships you're building and networking, the downs, it's big. It's a business, So you gotta manage, like, everything that comes with that, from, the lights being cut on to, decrease in clients or, client retention and things like that. And at the end of the day, just like you said, it is a huge career change. I was working in education, having a steady foundation, of money coming in and insurance, et cetera. As a business owner, you don't have that safety net. You don't have that backbone. So it's really, really hard when you start at ground zero, from zero, and you have to grind to make whatever that is, whether it's personal and or business.
There are so many gyms around. Mm-hmm. Tell us about your rigor.
Yeah.
Why should somebody come to Killer Fitness?
The quality that you get in terms of, the type of trainer I am. I'm very hands-on in terms of, I'm going to push you, I'm going to press you, I'm going to press that button. It's just the value in itself. Like, people, when they come to me, typically, they stay. So even if somebody come and they just get a sample session, they usually stay. I usually keep them. I get a lot of my clients based off referrals. They don't come from walking off the street. I'm like, even though I have, you can Google me, there's nobody that ever reached out, hey, I found you on Google. No, it was usually tell a friend to tell a friend. Like, somebody heard from somebody, or they said, hey, I have this trainer, he's a good guy, et cetera, et cetera. Always so assume it's ridiculously hard to do or something like that. Like, oh, I don't want to work out because of this, and make excuses and stuff like that. But in all actuality, us, our community, and our people, we need to take this, another level.
Safe.
It's definitely safe, if you are, fasting for Ramadan and you continue to train. Well, first and foremost, your body don't need to have drastic changes anyway. So if you're used to working out, then you can continue working out. But you might need to adjust what that look like, right? So we're fasting for every bit of 13, 14 hours. So, if you come into the gym, while you're fasting, I would say don't do too much cardiovascular activity. Light to moderate weight, focus on volume, not strength. Don't exhaust the body to where you dehydrate yourself, because then that causes, you'll probably pass out or something like that, right? But you, of course, you can always work out before you start fasting and or post, fasting. But it's safe. Like you're okay, you know, if you do it. You just don't press your body or push it to the limit to where you feel like you're gonna work out. Like I take on clients like they're my project. Like you're like my project. Like not for nothing, it's like your body becomes my body in a sense. Like whatever goal you wanna reach, I want you to reach that goal. But you have to want it for yourself, but I want it for you as well. So when you tell me, yo, I want to, you know, I want my core tightened up. I want to learn how to do a push-up. I want bigger legs, et cetera. Whatever it is, you know, I'm going to really, really hone into whatever that is, design a plan for you, customize it for you. I'm just a kid, you know, from North, born and raised, you know, 14th Street, 16th Ave, you know, North kid from the heart, you know, and I just, you know, I started this business, you know, I took a chance on myself. I betted on myself, gambled on myself. You know, I resigned from my position.
World. It's a 30 count, baby.